The tablet market has experienced a bit of a comeback since Apple started to ask,
"What's a computer?"
with their iPad Pro series. Even so, manufacturers including Google have steered clear of Android tablets, except for Samsung. This is the Galaxy Tab S6, Samsung's latest answer to the iPad Pro series. It's a premium Android tablet starting at $649 with top-of-the-line specs, some key accessories, and Samsung DeX for a laptop-like experience. In the last few years, everyone pretty much decided that the only pure tablet worth getting was from Apple. Let's see if that's really true, and maybe even see if this tablet can replace a laptop. Find out after I tell you about our sponsor, PDF Element Pro from Wondershare. PDF Element Pro is an advanced PDF editing software for Windows and macOS. It allows you to create, edit, convert, and OCR any of your PDF files. And if you're working with a bunch of PDFs at once, PDF Element Pro's got you covered, as it can perform PDF conversions, data extractions, and more in batches. That's a lot of features, but PDF Element Pro is actually very easy to use, so you don't have to worry too much about the learning curve. There's also a bunch of other features I never knew about that a PDF editing software can do, so if you want to try PDF Element Pro for free today and maybe even see Wondershare's whole suite of other great software products, make sure to check out the description box below to go visit their website. So first off, what are you getting in the box for $649? Of course, you get the tablet itself, which comes with the recent Snapdragon 855 processor, 6GB of RAM, and 128GB of storage. You also get an S Pen, a USB-C to USB-A cable, and a 15W power brick. While the price tag might seem high, you are getting one of the highest specs you can get with an Android device right now, and you also get a stylus without paying extra cash. The book cover keyboard is sold separately for a steep $179, but Samsung and stores like Best Buy are offering a 50% discount if you buy it with the Tab S6. You can also configure the tablet up to 8GB of RAM and 256GB of storage for $729, which is a reasonable upgrade. But yeah, here are the main price points you'll be playing with without the discounts, just in case you're region doesn't offer them. It's a fairly typical glass and aluminum build, but there's no question that this looks and feels very solid in its construction, even at just 5.7mm or 0.22 inches in thickness. There are solid, tactile power and volume buttons on the right side, as well as a slot for the microSD and a nano SIM if you get the LTE version. On the left, you just have the magnetic pins for the book cover keyboard. At the bottom, you have the USB-C port, as well as two speaker grills next to it, which are also at the top. Yes, the Tab S6 has quad stereo speakers, but unfortunately no headphone jack and no dongle either. Then at the back you get a dual lens camera, and on the front, of course, a front facing camera and a display with an in-display fingerprint reader. Weighing at just 420 grams or just under 15 ounces, the Galaxy Tab S6 is light enough to be used comfortably as a tablet, but substantial enough to keep that high quality feel. Those antenna lines, the aluminum, and the minimal bezels may make the Tab S6 look very similar to that other tablet, but I personally do think this tablet looks very sleek in its own way and can be a little playful as well, coming in three distinct colors: mountain gray, cloud blue, and rose blush. The Tab S6 also has a unique 16:10 aspect ratio. While that aspect ratio may sound too wide or too narrow, thanks to the minimal bezels and the small size, this tablet is easy to handle in both orientations. This aspect ratio is also appropriate for laptop mode, but you'll find that this display is much smaller than your typical laptop. This is reflected onto the keyboard size, which is good in terms of travel and key placement, but it is a small keyboard with an even smaller trackpad. This trackpad is really bad and might be the worst part about this device. Responsiveness may be decent, but multi-touch gestures and simple interactions like scrolling and highlighting text are inconsistent across many apps. The left and right clicks also require additional precision to function correctly. This trackpad is still better than not having one, but because it's bad, it's just not as big of an advantage as it should have been. You can use a wired or Bluetooth mouse, but do you really want to carry around a separate accessory? All in all, this trackpad just feels like a missed opportunity, and when compared to a laptop, this trackpad may be a deal breaker for many people. Another thing to mention is that the book cover keyboard comes in two parts. One, the keyboard attaches via the pins and covers the display, and two, the back cover and kickstand attaches via the magnets on the back, helped by this weird sticky adhesive. This two-part cover may sound a little strange, but this setup actually works really well and keeps everything together. The keyboard is a magnetic one, so it's easy to close open and to attach and detach. That hinge might not be as advanced in engineering as what's on the Surface Pro, but I think the kickstand itself is comparable, as it can adjust to practically any angle. Still not ideal for those tiny college desks or your lap, but for any other flat surface, this is fine. For the price, I also would have preferred this cover to have a more premium feel instead of this scratchy plastic material, but you know, it's not too bad. My other complaint about the design is the implementation of the S Pen, which Samsung decided to take a unique approach on. It's still a magnetic attachment which even charges and pairs the pen. Nice. What's not nice is that since the pen is sticking out like this, the tablet is uncomfortable to hold or lay on a table. The book cover keyboard does offer a nice little compartment to make sure you keep your pen where it is. The pen placement isn't a deal breaker and not a problem when in laptop mode, but something to keep in mind. As for the S Pen itself, it's excellent. It's a bit plasticky, but it's super light, has a flat rectangular shape, and this sort of soft touch coating makes it very nice to hold. This pen also has a soft replaceable tip, which makes a pen to screen interaction feel natural and not floaty. This isn't a scientific opinion, but I think this is the most responsive pen I've ever used. There's very little delay, beating my first gen Surface Pen as well as my first gen Apple Pencil. The battery life on the S Pen is just okay, but it still works without charge and pretty much charges instantly. I don't take full advantage of all the fun pen features, but this S Pen has been a very good tool for note taking and as a pointing device. Now, how is that Super AMOLED display that I've been showing off this entire time? As expected from Samsung, it's up there with the best of the best. This is a 10.5-inch almost corner-to-corner display with a resolution of 2560 by 1600, which is around 287 ppi. This is a sharp display, and like any other Super AMOLED display out there, you're getting bright rich colors here with silky deep blacks. This is also a very bright display, getting up to 500 nits of brightness, and actually one of the first tablets to be HDR10 Plus compatible, capable of playing true HDR content. Like I mentioned earlier, this is a 16:10 aspect ratio, so although this does favor landscape orientation over portrait, it feels natural either way. Putting it all together, this is an awesome display for all types of content consumption. The only downside is that it's capped at 60Hz versus the iPad Pro's ultra-smooth 120Hz display. The refresh rate isn't much of a factor to me, but I can see it being important for illustrators and gamers. As for the display size in laptop mode, I did write this entire script on the Tab S6, but I wouldn't say that it was a total breeze. My theory is that the 16:10 aspect ratio makes this a shorter display in landscape orientation, so my eyes and neck had to do a little more work than usual to look down at this relatively small display. However, this is a great aspect ratio for watching movies with relatively minimal letterboxing, and that book cover kickstand comes in real helpful in almost every situation. Speaking of which, let's talk about those quad stereo speakers that are Dolby Atmos enabled and tuned by AKG. Personally, these are the best sounding speakers I've had on a mobile device that includes all the laptops that I've had in the past. Not only do these speakers get amazingly loud, the audio quality is top notch, and you can definitely notice it when listening to podcasts and vocal dominant songs. By turning on Dolby Atmos, you do get very close to legitimate surround sound as well, despite not having a higher refresh rate. When considering the speakers and the HDR-capable display, the Tab S6 offers a ton in entertainment hardware. The cameras are pretty good too. You're probably not going to use these cameras for what you normally do, but the camera quality might still be important for some of you. On the back, you get a dual lens camera. One is 13 megapixels, while the other one is 5 megapixels. Yes, that is an ultra wide angle lens, which is fun, but obviously a step down from the main camera. The rear camera shots generally look great for a tablet. Focusing in night mode could use some work, but hey, good enough for a tablet. Samsung's post-processing is a little drastic, but most shots are pretty good even in low light situations, and the video quality is the same story with fairly smooth stabilization. On the other hand, the 8 megapixel front-facing camera is very important to me as I do a lot of video chatting on this tablet. In laptop mode, the camera placement is off to the left, which may be a little annoying for video chatting, but the quality is good both in terms of video and audio. For selfies, Samsung tends to put the highlights a little high as my black hair seemed gray in several situations, but man, I'm pretty impressed with the shots from this front-facing camera, especially the wide-angle ones. Moving on to software, I'll first talk about the pure tablet experience before discussing Samsung DeX and laptop mode. So Android is known to be bad as a tablet, but I didn't feel that way using the Tab S6. Samsung's One UI on top of Android 9 Pie is actually pretty well optimized and has a lot of features that users will appreciate. There's a facial recognition and the in-display fingerprint reader for biometric security, which are decently fast and conveniently function in both orientations. You are going to get a lot of pre-installed apps here, including Samsung's virtual assistant, Bixby, which is mapped to a long press on the power button for some reason. Disable that. But other than those kinds of apps, One UI offers a lot of useful stuff, including a universal dark mode, a blue light filter, a wind down feature, screen recording, kid mode for children, and a native file explorer with drag and drop and external cloud syncing. The Your Phone app or the Note 10's link to Windows feature aren't available here, but if you have a Galaxy phone, you can link it to the Tab S6 and text and call from this tablet. The biggest complaint I've heard about Android tablets is that the apps aren't optimized. They're locked in portrait orientation, they don't support split-screen multitasking, etc. Those complaints aren't wrong, but a few workarounds can resolve all those complaints very quickly. In developer options, you can force split-screen multitasking for any app. Then with an app like screen rotation control, you can force landscape orientation for any app you have. But what about those blown up apps not made for this orientation? Well, that's where the progressive web apps and the desktop class browser come in. Samsung's browser allows you to view desktop versions of websites and also install PWA websites just like regular apps with notification support and background syncing. Twitter is a very good example of this as the Android app just doesn't work for large screens, but with the PWA version, it's all good. You can even do some light creative work on here with Adobe Premiere Rush and Adobe Lightroom. The app gap is still there, especially with tablet games and dedicated creative apps for professionals, but for most use cases, the Play Store and the browser are more than enough. One complaint I do have about One UI and Android is their lack of gestures. The iPad has had multi-touch and navigational gestures for quite some time, which made iOS very usable on a big screen. The Tab S6 does have some gestures, like a new nav bar, swipe to a split-screen multitask, and double tap to wake, but there's not much else here to make using this big screen more fluid. But what this tablet does have over the iPad is Samsung DeX. It's definitely not perfect and does not make your tablet into a full-on Windows or Mac laptop, but this UI makes this tablet a lot more functional than ever before. You get desktop icons, keyboard shortcuts, and a taskbar at the bottom here with navigation buttons, pinned apps, notifications, and status icons. Most importantly, you get full-fledged windowed multitasking here, and besides Windows 2-in-1s, you won't get this experience on any other tablet. Yes, Samsung does include a version of windowed multitasking in their regular Android skin, but that feature just takes a bit too many steps to use and it's just not a practical experience. There is a bit of a loading time between DeX and One UI, but Samsung made the transition fairly seamless by letting you auto-launch DeX whenever the keyboard is attached. Here are the problems though. There are a few truly incompatible apps like Instagram that you can't resize or even move its window around. There's also no window snapping like there is on Windows, so it is a bit of a pain to move around and resize windows manually, especially with this trackpad. Quickly switching and closing apps can be a confusing experience as well. Even if you close the app on the taskbar or close it in the Alt Tab menu, it's not completely closed. If you want to completely end the app from your recent apps list, you have to go to Search and Tab and close it there. However, this recent apps menu and app switching are both slow to respond with shortcut keys, so it's sort of a pain to manage your recent apps with the keyboard and trackpad. Weirdly enough, this app switching and closing experience is much faster and better on regular Android. I actually ended up segregating my computer use between the two. DeX is mostly for multitasking, heavy work, and messaging, and One UI is for entertainment and light productivity. In terms of updates, Samsung may be slow at delivering major software updates like Android 10, 11, 12, but you know what? It will come eventually, and most of these features are already here on One UI. Plus, Samsung has been very good about security updates on basically all their Galaxy devices. I've also only had great customer support experiences with Samsung, so I'd say support is reliable from all sides. Let's finally talk performance and how that Snapdragon 855 and the 6GB of RAM handle everything. As you can expect from this processor, the day-to-day experience is a breeze and the Tab S6 handles everything very well even with apps getting updated in the background, using heavy apps, multiple apps running at the same time, and they do stay in memory for quite some time. But it is important to keep in mind if you're looking for a laptop replacement, that like any other mobile Android device out there, this powerful tablet will slow down in the upcoming years as future apps take up more memory and the processor slows down over time. But for now, the performance and gaming is a very nice experience on the Tab S6. The iPad may have more touch-friendly, casual, and family games available in the App Store, however, I believe Android is still the better platform for the more serious gamers. Android still has a wider range of support for external controllers, and with the ability to run console emulators from the PSP all the way to the GameCube, there's just a lot more here for the gamers. In addition, some Android games have support for keyboard and mouse, so you have that option as well. With a Bluetooth controller, the kickstand, the beautiful display and audio, top-notch performance, and maybe even a keyboard and mouse setup, the Tab S6 is just a fun time for gaming. I do wish the display had a higher refresh rate, but honestly, the Tab S6 might be one of the best portable gaming experiences out there. As for connectivity, I only have the Wi-Fi version, so I couldn't test out the LTE performance, but the Wi-Fi connection has been really strong and reliable wherever I went. The Tab S6 also has Bluetooth 5.0 and has been playing well with all my wireless devices, so no complaints there. There is a 7040 mAh battery in this thing, and I've had a good time with it. I use it heavily for around 3 to 4 hours every day after my work, switching between One UI and DeX, reading articles, watching YouTube videos, shows, and playing games every now and then. It lasts me about 2 to 3 days until I need to charge back up, so I get around 6 to 8 hours of on-screen time depending on what I'm doing, which isn't amazing, but it's also not bad. Charging does take a long time though, because it comes with just a 15-watt charger. Standby time is pretty good though. I noticed the battery go from 100% to 90% when I didn't use it for 2 days. All around, not amazing, but the Tab S6 has solid battery life. So putting all this together, let's answer some questions. Number one, is a Samsung Galaxy Tab S6 worth getting over the iPad Pro? If you're looking for a casual family/entertainment tablet, I would lean towards the iPad Pro because of the ease of use and the number of optimized apps available, but the real answer would be neither, as those price tags are just too high for those simple use cases. It'll probably be much better to get the regular iPad, which is only about $300. But in terms of getting stuff done, serious show binging, and gaming, I honestly give the edge to the Tab S6. Unpopular opinion, but I argue that Android and DeX are still more capable than the new iPad OS. It's a different story for creative professionals, as the iPad Pro has a lot more creative apps available on it, but for most people who need office apps, true multitasking, more advanced gaming capabilities, and closer to true computing, the Tab S6 just does all that stuff better. Now for question number two, can the Tab S6 replace a laptop? I think it is possible for people that just use Chromebooks or have very basic use cases on their Windows or Mac laptops, but for most of you watching, Samsung DeX and Android just aren't mature enough to compete with the decades of software development on Windows and macOS. Not only that, when considering the Tab S6 and its keyboard together, the price tag comes dangerously close to premium laptops, and it's just not going to be worth the compromises. In terms of the iPad to laptop scale, the Tab S6 is right there in between the two. It is an awkward spot, but maybe, just maybe, this is what you were looking for. Alright, that's going to do it for this video. Like it if you did, and please subscribe to the channel to see more videos like this. Let me know in the comments what you think. If you agree, disagree, or I'm just a complete idiot, I'll reply to most of you. Okay, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next one.